गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे इन एसएसटी वी विल गो थ्रू द सिक्स्थ चैप्टर दैट इज वेदर एंड क्लाइमेट एंड द टॉपिक इज व्हाट कॉजेज चेंजेस इन द क्लाइमेटिक कंडीशन. सो वी विल टॉक अबाउट इट बिकॉज द व्हेन द सन रेज फॉल ऑन द अर्थ सो इट इज नॉट डायरेक्ट ओनली एट सर्टेन एरिया ओनली इट फॉल्स डायरेक्ट दैट इज नियर द इक्वेटर एंड बिकॉज द अर्थ इज टिल्टेड so it gets the heat the sun rays it, the heatness it is variation there are variation on it some are somewhere it is little less rays are going slanting rays are going some are direct rays are going so it, that type of area the temperature is low and if there is direct rays then the temperature is very high like in Africa and all the countries which are in the equator in the equator zone so these they have high temperature and those who are, which are in the Antarctic where the rays are very slanting the sun rays does not reach there Antarctic and Arctic area so it is very there is no heat over there is no warm only cold because there is snow throughout the year. So we will go through it that the climatic changes how does it affect us. We will go through all this in this I will explain you about it and revision test I had told you about the diagram of chapter 5 that you will do it in your class group. Okay, so we will start with it and students whatever I am giving you do it in your which I write it on the in the classwork in homework that do it in your rough copy. Or do it in your fair copy then also you again and again ask that in which copy we have to do so you just go through the classwork and homework properly the notice and then you do your work okay so in question answers if I will give then you will do it in your fair copy and all this revision work revision test that you can do it in your rough copy or if you have test copy thin copy in that also you can do it so let's get started
let's get this
Now student, we had already talked about the weather and climate and the difference between it. Now what causes changes in the climatic conditions? What are the causes which the climate change? So from heat from sunlight, air temperature and water bodies are the main factors affecting the climate and temperature of a place. What are they? Sunlight. Air temperature, water bodies, these and affect the climate and temperature of a place. The earth receives most of its heat from the sun. We all know from where we get the heat, it is from the sun. So the sun rays are parallel when they reach the earth. When they reach the earth, they are parallel, they are straight. But some parts of the earth gets more sunlight and hence they get heated more. Whereas other part receives poor sunlight, less sunlight and hence remain cool. So why this has happened? Because the earth rotates on its axis and continuously revolves around the sun too. And it is tilted also. So these motion expose different parts of the earth to the sun at different times of the year. Because the earth is rotating on its axis. So some which is near the sun, direct to the sun, so it is that portion is hot and which is away, it is cold. And hence the change of seasons is experienced. So this much you have understood. Once again I will read it. Heat from sunlight, air temperature and water bodies are the main factors affecting the climate and temperature of a place. The earth receives most of its heat from the sun. The sun rays are parallel, straight, when they reach the earth. But due to the tilt of the earth, I told you now it is tilt. So due to the tilt of the earth on its axis, the rays do not heat up the earth uniformly. It does not heat everywhere same. Somewhere it is more heat, somewhere it is less heat. So some parts of the earth get more sunlight and hence they get heated more. Whereas other part receives poor sunlight and hence remain cool like Antarctica, Arctic region, Antarctic region. So the earth rotates on its axis and continuously revolves around the sun too. These motion expose different parts of the earth to the sun at different times. Sometimes the sun faces north area, east area, sometimes west area, sometimes. So it is different at different times, and hence the change of seasons is experienced. So all these factors we will go through. So I will only explain you today equator. Equator is the biggest gainer of sunlight. I had already told you on the earth, the middle part equator, it is the biggest gainer of sunlight. See in one of the diagram also, it is shown in which chapter it was that diagram. This diagram, see, rotation of the earth, see sunlight, and this is the middle part equator. So here the equator gets the maximum sunlight, maximum heat comes here only. Okay, so the equator receives maximum sunlight throughout the year. The sun's rays directly fall on the equator and hence it remains hot because it is near, directly going, the heat is rays, the rays are going near the equator, so it is remains hot. As we move up or down, now if we move down to the equator, to the poles, the amount of direct sunlight reduces. So the sunlight reduces, it becomes less. So these areas receive the slanting rays of the sun. Slanting means a little bit like that, not straight, little bit tilted. So these areas receive the slanting, teda thoda sa rays of the sun. Further, the rays near the poles are scattered, and near the poles it becomes scattered. It does not reach there. So whereas at the equator, the same amount of sun rays is concentrated on a smaller area, and near the equator area, the sun rays is very smaller. It is direct, so it is very hot over there. Hence, areas near the pole are cooler than those near the equator. Now you understand now why it is cooler, because the sun rays is not there near the pole area, north or south pole. But it in the middle area, equator area, it is direct sun rays, and that is why it is very hot. And the polar area is cool. So today I have explained you this much, and then I will in the group I will give you the diagram test of chapter 5. Okay. Thank you.